Amigos de R de Rudo, estamos con Jeff Jarrett. We're with the King of the Mountain. How is this experience now with WWE?
It's been amazing. I've been back 9 months, and for me to get the opportunity, especially to come to Mexico City, the history that I have here, and so to be a part of WWE Live, promoting WWE Live, the card that we're bringing, it's a super show from Roman Reigns to Braun Strowman, to Becky Lynch, Rey, Andrade, Rey, Kane. It's an amazing experience.
You returned to Mexico now as a Hall of Famer, a WWE Hall of Famer. You've been recognized as a mega champion in AAA, one of the most important and founder of Impact Wrestling. How do you feel about being recognized as a Hall of Famer in WWE?
When I got the call, and I've told this story, I was as surprised or shocked as anyone when they asked me to join the Hall of Fame. But as it rolled along and turned out, it was a very humbling experience for Road Dogg, one of my best friends, to be able to induct me 32 years to the day from the time I had my first match till 32 years later, inducted into the Hall of Fame. That was really special. But that's opened other doors in my career. I'm a third generation. My family got in the business, my grandmother, in the 1940s. She never wrestled, but she got in and worked her way up on the business side of things. And then my dad wrestled, promoted, and then I followed in the family footsteps. And so for me to have the opportunity to go into the Hall of Fame, and now my role within WWE, promoting WWE Live, a global brand that promotes shows, just in the last 90 days, Singapore, China, all through Europe, Saudi Arabia, South America, we're coming to Mexico at the end of this month. It's a really, really amazing time for me.
You know very well Mexico, and you know people in Mexico, very important people. It's possible something bigger than a WWE live show. Like a pay-per-view or something like that.
Oh, yeah. Well, you never know. Like I said, we just did a show in Saudi Arabia. We're doing Raw and SmackDown, be produced in Manchester, UK this Friday. We do shows all over the globe. So Mexico City, with the history, Lucha Libre has been in this country over 100 years. And so the opportunity will present itself at the right time. The market's there. It's all through South America, Central America, and Mexico City is like the, it's like the hub. It's the New York City of Latin America, and so the opportunity will present itself. I would love nothing more to do a big either television or pay per view event. It'd be special here.
You tell me something about WWE brands. Hey, what are your thoughts about? When's the wars? You were part of Monday Night Wars.
Oh, the Wednesday Wars. Wednesday. Okay. It's great for business. It's always has been, always will be. And a lot of people say you can't duplicate the 90s of the WCW, WWF, and you can't. But what's unique about the Wednesdays here is it's just a real special time because we are launching our third brand on network television, which is very special. And then the new brand, I'll say it on a network that's had wrestling, TNT's had wrestling. So when you launch that, but in this climate and in the 90s, Netflix and streaming services weren't around. So live content today is more important than ever, exponentially more important. So the stakes are higher. Obviously, with Friday nights, WWE's on broadcast network in the States on Fox. We're on USA Network on Monday. So it's a different climate, 3 hours on Monday, 2 hours on Friday, and then you have the combined 4 hours of live content on Wednesday. So I'll say it is without question a wrestling boom as it relates to televised wrestling.
Yeah, you can pick one male and one female wrestler from Mexico. Who could be that wrestlers?
And you're talking about like I'm not. Yeah. I don't let you in on my secrets. No, there's so much talent here in Mexico that it's And it goes, you know, with AAA and CMLL and you know, all the independent promotions and Crash. The rosters are deep. A couple of years ago, it wouldn't have been as competitive on the WWE roster. But now you look at the WWE roster, Rey, you know, it goes without saying, the most famous luchador of all time. But then, you know, we have Andrade, Humberto, Raul, Garza. The list goes on and on. So, you never know who's going to get the next opportunity to become, to come from Mexico and get on the grandest stage.
And let's face it, you were in charge of Mexican diet, throwing tortillas to the crowd. which is the most important or impactful memory you have of the Mexican crowd?
Oh wow, that's that to say one memory from a Mexican crowd, that'd be hard. There were several instances that we had to have security to get us in the arena. Me and Karen would go to the ring. I'd throw my tortillas, I'd throw my nopales and do my deal, and Karen would be mad at me and say, let's get it out of here. You're going to get us killed. And we'd have security out of the building. But there was a lot. There was a real good love-hate relationship between me and the Mexican crowd. But those Rudo days currently are behind me.
Great. Finally, can you send a message for RD Rudo fans and invite them to WWE live show?
You know, the Rudo fans, I'll say this. You don't really nowadays come watch a WWE event. You come experience it. And what we're offering on the 30th of this month, it goes without saying. It's a real experience. It's a super show. Over 30 superstars are coming from Raw and SmackDown. Roman, Becky, Braun, the list goes on and on. You also have Kane, without saying, a legend in MMA, and now he stepped into a WWE ring, which is really amazing. And then, you know, it's like I said, I've spoken with Rey. It's a homecoming of sorts. He gets to come back, maybe for the last time ever, to perform in front of his crowd, his home crowd. And then in the main event, we get a cage match. And you don't really just watch a cage match. You certainly experience that. So The Fiend defending the Universal title. And currently The Fiend is the most, he's the hottest box office attraction in the world. And so Mexican fans love their masked wrestlers. So you don't want to miss November 30th, that's for sure.
Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you.